We were curious at Spotify to know which rock star mums were the most popular with our users. So we were able to compile this list based on streaming activity from our 24 million active users around the globe. So basically, these are the top five most streamed mums on Spotify.
So let's start with number five, Britney Spears.
Right. Now, Britney has been creating a lot of buzz lately because there's been some news that she's about to embark on a residency in Las Vegas. She's going to have this gigantic Vegas show, much like Celine Dion and Shania Twain has or have had. And it's going to kick off in the fall. And, you know, Britney's one of those artists, Ralitza, who has had her fair share of ups and downs over the years, but she has a very, very loyal fan base. And because of her back catalogue of really addictive hits, fans like to go back and listen to some of her early material as well as her newer stuff. So I'm not at all surprised that she's made it in our top five.
Number four, Alicia Keys. She has a new single out.
She does. She has a new song. It's called Tears Always Win. But as mums, Ralitza, we know that crying doesn't mean you're going to get what you want. Alicia Keys had a baby boy about 2 years ago, and she's very good at juggling motherhood with her superstardom and also with campaigning for HIV and AIDS awareness. I'm guessing Spotify users gravitate towards her because of her amazing, gorgeous voice, and she just churns out great songs.
Absolutely. And then we have Adele, who is the only non-American on this list.
Right, and she's also the youngest mum on this list. She's only 25 years old, and she's the newest mum. She had her baby in October. Adele had such a massive hit with her last album, 21, and this album has so many addictive, alluring, stunning tracks on it that it's really hard to stay away from it. I'm pretty guilty of streaming one of the songs from this album every second or third day. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if I alone am responsible for her being on this list.
You brought her there to number
three. I did, but a little interesting tidbit. She just turned 25, and she celebrated her 25th birthday by attending the concert of the mummy rock star who's at number two on our list.
Absolutely, and that is Beyoncé, who has stirred a little bit of controversy with her travels recently.
Yeah, she did create a bit of a buzz with her trip to Cuba, but she's attracting a lot of attention at the moment because of her big international tour. At the moment, she's in Europe. I believe she's in Ireland. An amazing tour. Every time Beyoncé goes on tour, it's always a massive event. And at a recent show in London at the O2 Arena, she actually brought her daughter, who's one, Blue Ivy, into the show. There was a moment where Beyoncé was singing and she held the hand of her little girl, and her little girl was wearing these gigantic headphones to protect her growing little eardrums from the huge cacophony of noise that was in the stadium. I can't imagine what that experience was like for that little girl.
Thank God for those headphones. And
exactly.
Ta-da, at number one, it is Pink.
It is Pink. Absolutely. And I'm glad she's at number one because she's been getting some heat lately from some fans who are a bit upset with her. She had to skip a concert in Birmingham, England recently because she was sick. She's feeling much better now, but she was really unwell, and she never cancels concerts, but she had to cancel this one. And fans got really nasty online and sent, you know, some really nasty tweets, some nasty messages to her. So she actually addressed this in a letter earlier this week, and she said, okay, everybody, can you just cut me some slack? I'm a working mom, and she has a two-year-old. She pointed out that two-year-olds, as we know, pick up a lot of germs.
Absolutely, and we pick up a lot from them as well.
Exactly.
I will say that.
She said, give me a break here. And it was actually a really good letter. It was very tough. She's a tough girl. So she deserves to be at number one.
Yeah, well, they look fabulous, but they're also humanizing the mommy role. They've done very well. Of course, it helps to be rich, but still.
It does.
It shows you can be successful and beautiful.
Well, you know, as I was looking down this list, I wonder how many nannies there are between all these women, and can they maybe push one or two my way? Because I could use some of that help.
That's a very good idea if they're listening.
I don't think it's
going to
happen.
We got you covered, Shannon.
Happy Mother's Day, Ralitza.
Same to you, Shannon Cook. Thank you so much.